Okay, one thing that I really love about Swift is that it's not just something to do in the summer. A lot of my friends are looking for things for their kids to do. I wasn't looking for something for my kids to do as much as I was looking for them to grow as a person. And not just a way to spend their day, but a way to develop who they are. And that's what I love about Swift, because from the minute they get up into the minute they go to bed, it's not activities as much as it is, it's not so much doing as it is being. And when you're at Swift, it's what they are that I love. There's this respect for nature that they carry on at home when they come back. There's a respect for kids that come from different places and with different practices than they might be familiar with. And they're developing the respect and interest in new parts of the world and new kinds of ways of living. So for me, it's not just the awesome activities, the archery, all the fun things they get to do. It's the way they get to be during the days that matters to me. Truly, I just am so thankful for that opportunity.
Oh, man.
I am, because you don't get that. And this is the other thing I want to say, is that most camps that my friends send their kids to are very skill oriented. It's about doing better when they come back. And for me, Swift is not about doing better, it's about being better. And I know we're not supposed to be, well, that whole be better business, but I do, it's not about skill as much as it is about personhood. I guess that's where your tree of life comes in. Because I really don't care if they're riflery or they're archery or how many fish they catch. I care about how the way they grow in those other important ways. It was uncomfortable putting trust in someone to watch my boys, but it absolutely paid off. I don't worry from the time they get on that bus until the time they get home. When I was picking a camp, of course I looked at the facilities, the price, but what I really paid attention to was the way the directors interacted with the children. And I felt from the very beginning that there was respect, kindness, and compassion. And that is why I feel so comfortable with the boys being there. Another reason I'm so grateful that they had the opportunity to be at Swift Nature Camp is that as much as I thought as a mom I was providing everything they needed, I realized there were opportunities for them to grow that I was not able to provide, that came in a group setting, that came in the beautiful nature outdoors, that came from being away from me. And because of that, they have developed far greater independence, resourcefulness, a willingness to stick it out when things get tough. That when I'm there, they're willing just to dump on me. And because I wasn't with them, and they were with counselors and directors who had been trained to bring this out of them, I really noticed it when they came home. That when we had similar kinds of challenging situations at home, they were turning inward rather than looking to me to make the situation work out. That whole play with a purpose, purposeful play. And they think they're just having a great group game, but they're learning to get along with that difficult kid in the cabin, and they're making sure he doesn't get left behind. And the one thing my oldest son has said that has made it very valuable for him as a college student is resourcefulness. That he said, what I learned from going on these out-of-camp experiences was I had to be resourceful, and that I could rely on myself and I could rely on the people in my group, and we'd still be able to get it done even if the conditions weren't perfect. And as I was leaving to talk today, that was one of the things he said, I'm so thankful that Swift taught me to be resourceful. I thought, me too. Yeah, one thing the boys have really appreciated is that their little personality traits were recognized, developed, and appreciated, whether it be around the campfire, within the different games they played with their cabin mates. And even though they each have different strengths and weaknesses, they came home feeling like they were a valued part of that community. And that's an experience they didn't always have in their elementary schools or their junior highs. absolutely a part of camp that I'm so grateful for is the fact that it's tech-free. Because everywhere they go today, the grocery store line, the movie theater, you see a group of kids and they're looking down rather than looking up at each other. And at camp, they find each other's eyes again and they talk to each other face to face. And I've learned that from having my sons who went to SWIFT now go off to college, the one thing the professors are finding is that the students don't have this ability to work things out face to face, and that they rely on email and Facebook groups and texting, and that this generation does need to develop the face to face talking it out skills. And I love that SWIFT offers that to the kids, that they don't even have the opportunity to rely on technology if they wanted to. One of the parts of camp that I appreciate from the camp experience is that even though they're going to the northern woods of Wisconsin, where it's beautiful and peaceful, people come from different walks of life. And even though I'm not able to send my kids to different places, they're still able to experience people from different places. And while that's been very beneficial, sometimes it also has a challenging moment, such as there was one boy in my older son's cabin and they did not see eye to eye. They tend to rub each other the wrong way. But the benefit of that was that the counselors were trained well enough where they could intervene and help these two boys learn not only to work it out, but actually develop a real relationship. Because after my older son came home, when he wanted to communicate with friends from camp, this boy that he originally had so much difficulty with was one of the boys that he really wanted to stay in touch with. And it's been the same, even though all three boys are very different in personality, I think they each have gotten this benefit, which is that at home in their community, being a strong athlete's a very highly important skill. They don't have that skill or that interest even. And when they came to SWIFT, they realized that they had other skills and they had other interests that were significant and validated. But first of all, they were recognized. They were seen by their counselors. And then they were nurtured by the directors. And all of a sudden it went from being good at sports is my way to be recognized, is I can just be myself and be recognized. You know, I'm enough, just as I am. And I think they all came home with, I am significant, I am something. And that has been lasting for them, for sure. I think my husband was more nervous about me sending the kids off because he would have to stay home with me when I would be nervous. But as it turns out, from the very first letter that arrived home, every letter had good news and good stories, which made it much easier to be away. But the flip side to that was, while I sent them to camp so that they could grow, I found that I was doing my own growing at home, where I had to stretch into my own discomfort to do what was better for them. And I didn't expect that I would get something out of camp. And I learned that it really does take a village to raise a family, and that when you pick the right people to be a part of your village, it's comfortable and reassuring and even relieving to bring some people into that community to help raise your child. I didn't get to go to camp. I chose not to go to camp as a child. I didn't want to be away from home. But I didn't fully understand everything I was missing. And now I absolutely would love to have the opportunity of camp mom, or moms go to camp, because to spend that much time with people that you enjoy, doing activities that you enjoy in such a beautiful setting, we all need that cycle of rest and pleasure and rejuvenation. I absolutely would love to come to camp. And when I came last summer and got to spend time sitting around the living room and fireplace, I didn't want to leave. It's a great place to be. It used to be when I was a kid, and even when my older sons were little, that you'd drive around the neighborhood and there were kids outside all day. You know, from sun up till sundown, those kids were outside playing. But I've seen a real change in that. That especially as the kids get older, by ages 11 and 12, you don't see the kids outside when you're driving around. The younger ones are still there, the older ones are working, but I really wondered what happened to those kids between 11 and 16, And it turns out a lot of them are inside on Facebook, playing their video games on their cell phones, and they're not outside in the fresh air playing the group activities that summer offers. I also just think play. You know, our culture has gotten so away from play. You know, we send our kids to camp to develop their computer skills, to develop their athletic skills, to develop their academic skills. It's all about being better, or doing better, really, more than being better. And what I love about SWIFT is that even though there's a purpose to the play, the kids don't know that. And what they know is they're playing, which just doesn't happen anymore. Even with when they're home between their busy schedules, the video games, busy parents, busy siblings, to get a group of kids in your age group playing together for an extended length of time, it just doesn't happen anywhere else. Absolutely, the counselors have been a huge part of why my boys keep coming back, and a part of all their good stories too. Because I know they get from the counselors the sense that they are heard and that they matter in their cabin and in the camp experience. My son's favorite book came from his counselor, read it to them before they went to bed, The Giver. And to this day, he keeps a copy on the shelf in his room with all his favorite things. I have Christmas cards from counselors that come every year. My boys have gone on to stay Facebook friends with their counselors. It's not just a person who's watching them or teaching them for the session. It's someone who really becomes a true and trusted friend. My favorite Steve-O story is the kids called him and he answered and they talked for a while. And then he said, well, I have to go. I'm in church. The kids were like, we talked for 5 minutes before he said that.